Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. I hope all of you are fine by the grace of Almighty in this pandemic situation. I am Mohammad Muazzam Hussain, lecturer physics, Milestone College, Uttara, Dhaka. Today, I start a new chapter, chapter 3, force, and I discuss some important topics from this chapter, that is inertia, force, non-contact force, balance force, unbalanced force, fundamental force, and some comprehensive question. So, my dear students, let's start our today's class. First of all, we discuss about inertia. What is inertia? The characteristics that a stationary body wants to be stationary, or a body in motion wants to keep its motion unless a force is applied, is called inertia. Type of inertia. There are two types of inertia. Inertia of rest. An object stays where it is placed until something else move it. Inertia of motion. An object will continue at the same speed until a force acting on it. Now we discuss about force. Force is that quantity the application of which a stationary object start move, and a body moving with a uniform velocity change its velocity. Force is denoted by F. Force is a vector quantity. Unit of force is capital N. Dimension of force MLT inverse 2. My dear students, now we discuss about contact force and non-contact force. Contact force. A force acting between two bodies in contact is called a contact force. For example, if you pushing a car, here a contact between you and car. If you pushing a table toward the wall, here a contact between you and table. This is our contact force. Non-contact force. A non-contact force acts between the bodies that are not in direct connect. For example, gravitational force. If I release this marker, it's going to downward. There is a attraction force acting toward the earth. This is non-contact force. My dear students, now we discuss about balance force, unbalanced force. Balance force. If the resultant of all the forces acting on a body is zero, the forces are called balance force. I repeat, if the resultant of all the forces acting on a body is zero, the forces are called balance force. If I applied this body 100 newton from this side and same magnitude forces applied opposite side, this body, we know force is a vector quantity. Here these two forces direction are opposite, but they are same magnitude. So resultant force of this on this body is F equal F1 plus minus F2. So will be 100 minus 100, that means 0. Okay, the resultant force or net force on this body is 0. So we can say that this force is balance force. Okay, unbalanced force. If the resultant forces acting on the body is not zero, the forces are called unbalanced force. I repeat, if the resultant forces acting on the body is not zero, the forces are called unbalanced force. Here I applied 100 Newton force from this side, and opposite side if I applied 80 Newton force, the resultant force will be 20 Newton. Okay, this is unbalanced force. Okay, my dear students, now we discuss about fundamental force. Fundamental forces are the four primary forces in the nature, and all other types of forces can be derived from them. That means all other forces depend on fundamental forces. These four types of fundamental forces are gravitational force, electromagnetic force, weak nuclear force, strong nuclear force. I repeat, these four kinds of fundamental force. Number one, gravitational force, electromagnetic force, weak nuclear force, strong nuclear force. My dear students, now we discuss about three comprehensive questions. First one is, why do passengers lean forward when the moving bus suddenly brakes? When a sudden brake is applied in a moving bus, the passengers lean forward because of inertia of motion. When a bus is in motion, the passengers of the bus is also in the same speed of the bus. When the bus stops suddenly, the lower part of the body also becomes stationary with the bus, but the upper part of the passenger's body moves forward due to the inertia of motion. I think you got it. My dear students, now we discuss about comprehensive question 2. Why do passengers lean backward when a stationary bus suddenly start moving? When the bus start moving suddenly, the lower part of the passenger's body start moving forward with the bus. The upper part of the body tends to remain in the position of rest due to its inertia of rest. As a result, the passengers lean backward as the bus starts. Now we discuss about comprehensive question 3. The question is, how do you get the idea of inertia and force from Newton's first law? From Newton's first law of motion, we observe that a body cannot change its state on its own. If the body is at rest, it tends to remain at rest forever. And if it is in motion, it tends to keep on motion with uniform speed for all time. To change the state of a body, something external must be applied. That is the external cause which changes or tends to change the state of an object is called force. Thus, from Newton's first law, we get the idea of inertia and force. My dear students, not for today. Thank you very much, all of you. Stay with me. Allah Hafiz.